We'll continue this problem. Force experienced by a charged particle kept in magnetic field is Q into V cross B. Suppose if the charge is electron, its charge is 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 coulomb. So 9.1 10 power minus 31 V cross B. Okay, this is Vx, Vy, Vz. B, Vx, By, Bz. So 9.1 Ijk minus 4, minus 2, minus 4x, minus 2y, 0, Bx, 2x, minus 2z, 3x. So simplify this, you will get a vector which represents four sums. Okay, we will take up the next numerical. If two vectors are perpendicular, then their dot product is 0. We will use that idea to calculate a constant. Suppose here, if vector P is equal to 7a x cap minus z cap, vector Q is x cap minus 4y cap plus z cap, find a if the two vectors are perpendicular. Correct? So find P dot Q, Ax, Bx, Qx, okay? 7a into 1 is 7a, mine y term is not there, then z minus 1 into 10 minus 10 is equal to 0. Dot product of two vectors is 0 because angle is 90 degree, cos 90, 0. So 7a is equal to 10, a is 10 by 7. Okay, so now with these basic operations, we will now look at vector calculus. Now we need to study how vectors change in space. Correct? Calculus dealing with vectors which change in space is called as vector calculus. We have to understand, for example, if you have a charge Q here, we all know electric field decreases as inverse square law, like this, correct? See here, the electric intensity decreases as 1 by r square. It varies in space in this fashion. We need a mathematical tool to represent this kind of behavior. See this? Here is a field whose magnitude changes. It moves in the in this direction, its intensity is decreasing. For example, look at this x component of this field. Let us say this is electric field due to a point charge Q. Okay? Now electric field here is more, lesser. It is varying as 1 by r square. Electric field along the x-axis is changing. All directions it is changing. How to represent this? Look at another example. Suppose if you have a magnetic field, if you have a current flowing in this direction, the magnetic field according to right hand thumb rule would look like this. Correct? This is a magnetic field. Now how to represent this magnetic field? A vector which forming closed loop. It is forming what is called as curl. Correct? Here this vector is forming what is known as divergence. Now, what is the difference between divergence and curl? What is it? Why electric field is called as divergent vector? Why magnetic field is said to possess curl? What is divergence? What is curl operation? What is gradient? We will learn these three basic vector differential process. Okay? Now, first one, divergence of a vector. Okay, very important in the exam. What is divergence? Divergence operation helps us to evaluate amount of physical quantity emerging from a point or going into a point. Divergence means you have a point from which some physical quantity is emerging. Correct? Imagine tip of the fountain from which the water emerges in all directions. And the water, when it comes out, its velocity changes as it moves. Correct? So divergence operation helps us to evaluate net outflow or inflow of a physical quantity. This is the significance of this operation. In electrostatics, we find divergence of electric field to calculate charge, to calculate charge density, to charge. We study various parameters using divergence. In magnetostatics, we do curl. Magnetic fields possess curl. Now, how to represent this vector? We have a differential operator. This differential operator is called as del operator. What is del operator? Del operator, del vector is given by dou x into x cap, dou by dou y into y cap, plus dou by dou z into z cap. See this? It is a unit, it is a differential operator which can be performed on any vector. It is a spatial differential operator. So this del operator we use, this differential operator we use to differentiate vectors. How they change in space. Okay? Spatial variation of a vector is studied through this. For example, now divergence, how do we write it? Divergence is given by here del dot vector. Divergence of a vector A is equal to here dou by dou x into x component of vector. Okay, let the vector A be, see this, 3x x cap, 3y what y cap plus z. Okay, now this is x component. Next, del second term is dou ay by dou y. Y change in y component along y axis plus dou az by dou z. See this, divergence operation gives us net outflow or inflow of a physical quantity. It is done through multiplying this del operator with the vector. See this, it is taking dot product of these two vectors, x component of this dou by dou x component of A, so multiply that here, x component of this, y component of this del operator is this, y component of vector A is this, multiply them, dou ay. Take dot product of this and this, this here. Correct? So this is the definition of divergence operator. Now in this case, suppose if I apply divergence of this, x component differentiate with respect to x, divergence of A is equal to 3x when you differentiate with respect to x, 3. Next, differentiate 3y with respect to y, 3. Plus 1. Differentiate 1 with respect to z, 0. So it is. See, when you perform divergence operation, you get a scalar. Do you see that? When you perform divergence operation on a vector, you get a scalar quantity. This is very important, please see this. Now, electric field has divergence. Magnetic field does not have divergence. So, electric field is said to be irrotational. Magnetic field is said to be solenoid. Okay? So, now I take an example. See here? Electric field is said to be irrotational. It has divergence. Correct? Irrotational means it is changing like this. in all directions. It is not forming closed loops, it is divergence. Correct? If this is a positive charge. If it is a negative charge, field lines will move towards the charge. This is divergence. If it is negative charge, it will be convergence. Correct? So, in this is the example for irrotation. Whereas magnetic field is solenoidal, it forms closed loops. So, now we will solve an expression. Okay? We will solve a numerical using this idea. In the exam, you get such questions. Show that the electric field is irrotational if E is equal to 3x square minus into x cap minus 11y into y cap. Okay? So, how to show that? Find its divergence. If its divergence is not 0, then it is irrotational. If its divergence is 0, then it is solenoidal. Here, it should be non-zero. Let us see. Del dot E. Okay? Divergence of E. E is called as, here, del dot E. Dou Ex by dou X. Plus dou Ey by dou Y. Dou Ez by dou Z. See, right hand side is not a vector. You get a scalar quantity. So, differentiate Ex with respect to Xx. Okay. Differentiate Ey minus 11y. Minus 11. See, RHS is non-zero. So, it is irrotational. Correct? This is non-zero. Hence, electric field vector is irrotational. Suppose if the vector is irrotational, if a constant is there in the vector, we can calculate. I'll give you now a numerical on how we use divergence operation to calculate some parameters like electric flux density. See, the Gauss law, which you will learn later, is given by del dot D is equal to rho. Divergence of electric flux density is equal to charge density. So, in the exam, you know what? You will be given vector D. Vector D is minus x cube, x cap, minus plus y square, y cap, 4z, z cap. Okay? This is electric flux density, coulomb per meter square. Fine. Okay? Charge density. Right? How to do? Take divergence of this. Find charge density, let us say at 1, 1, minus 1. So now, divergence of D is equal to del dot D is equal to dou dx by dou x. Please here, change of x component along x axis. It is right hand side is a scalar. Dou dy by dou y. Dou dz by dou z. Is it clear? So now, minus 3x square. Differentiation of this with respect to x. Here, differentiation with respect to y, 2y, here, minus 4, correct? Now, divergence del dot D itself is rho according to this law. Now, at what points? 1, 1, minus 1, rho at 1, 1, minus 1 is equal to, put x is equal to 1, minus 3, y is equal to 1, 2, 4, so it will be equal to coulomb per meter. Correct? Minus 3 plus 2 is minus 7 plus 2 minus 5. Correct? So, this is how divergence is very important. It gives us net outflow, net inflow at a point. It is used to represent variation in electric field in electrostatics. Next,
another important parameter, important operation called as curl. What is curl operation? Curl operation is curl of a vector. What does it represent? It represents whether a vector forms a closed loop. Curl means forming closed loop. Electric field is diverging, correct? So if you take curl of electric field, it is always zero. That is why we say it is irrotational. Curl of a vector, this operation helps us to represent magnetic field. Magnetic field vector for a current carrying conductor I, we know it is forming closed loops like this, correct? So curl operation can be used to represent magnetic field, flux density. Now how do we define this? Again we use a del operator. Del curl of a vector is equal to del cross B. Okay? What is del operator? We all know del operator is dou by dou x x cap, dou by dou y y cap, dou by dou z z cap. This is del differential operator. What is B? Let B, vector B be 3y cube x cap minus 2x square y cap plus 4x z cap. Please observe this. X component has all y terms, correct? X component is varying along y. Look at this y component. You have its variation along x axis, correct? Z component has x term. X component has y term. Y component has x term. So this kind of vectors will have curl, correct? So now del cross B is, we use now curl definition determinant, unit vector I, j, k. Now del dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, correct? Now x B x, B y, B z. Right? So we will now expand this determinant I, j, k, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, bx, 3y cube, by minus, this is bx, this is by, this is bz, okay, minus 2x square plus 4x. Right? So we will now evaluate the determinant. What do you get? Curl of B, this is called as curl of B, is equal to I into, see here, dou by dou y of 4x, correct? Minus dou by dou z of minus 2x square. Next, minus j. These two, dou by dou x of 4x minus dou by dou z of 3y cube. This and this, and you have to multiply this. Next, last, plus k cap, k, dou by dou x into minus 2x square, dou by dou x into minus 2x square minus dou by dou y into 3y cube. Correct? So curl vector, curl of a vector, you will see now, produces a vector. Whereas in the previous case, a divergence of a vector produces a scalar quantity. Correct? We calculated divergence of electric flux density. What did we get? Volume, charge density. Charge density is a scalar. But here curl of a vector produces a vector. So if you simplify this, curl of this vector B, del cross B is equal to I into differentiation of x with respect to y 0 minus, here this is x, this is z, 0, correct? Minus j into dou by derivative of this with respect to x 4 minus derivative of this with respect to z 0 plus k into
derivative of this with respect to x minus 2x square minus 4x minus derivative of this with respect to y 9y. Correct? So this vector will be like this. This vector is minus 4j and plus k into minus 4x minus 9. This is the expression for curl of magnetic field. This, what does this give us? Curl can be, curl of magnetic field is related to current. See here, Ampere's law in differential form can be related like this. Correct? Curl of magnetic field is related to current density. This is Maxwell's equation. We will study that later. So you must realize, curl operation is very important to represent fields which are rotating. Right? So we'll solve, we know that for magnetic fields, curl is non-zero. Correct? Whereas for electric field, its curl is zero. It does not form closed loop, it is divergent. So magnetic field is said to be solenoidal. Electric field is divergent. Magnetic field is solenoidal because curl is non-zero. Correct? Now, I give you a simple numerical. Find see here constant A if the vector, see this 4y square x cap minus 2x y cap is solenoidal. Correct? The vector is solenoidal, means it is irrotational. So therefore, if it is solenoidal, then the vector is its divergence is zero. Correct? So find its curl, its divergence, and equate it to zero. Since they are saying it is solenoidal, means it is rotating like this, this vector, its divergence is zero. So now del dot E is equal to dou Ex by dou x plus, when you take divergence operation, right hand side is a scalar, dou Ey by dou y, dou Ez by dou z. It is mentioned its divergence is zero. It has curl, its divergence is zero. So dou Ex by dou x, you have here the constant, let it be, see here, 2 into Ax plus 3. Okay, I'll rewrite it. See here, 2x A plus 3x into y cap. So we have to find this constant A. Now differentiate this with respect to x, 0, because this is y square. Now y term, does it have y term here? Let us change this numerical. Square A